Yeah! Hello, stream. It's me, Panties. This is game three of Ozymandias, Metal Reaver versus Stango Hot Mashed Potatoes. I'm not surprised. Even Stango can't carry Hot Mash this hard. So let's see what happens. Hey, Allison. I thought you were coming. That's like half the reason I came. Alright, so... Wow! Dead even. It seemed like they were down by a lot, but I guess they tied it up. Uh-oh, Stango's applying the pressure to Ozzy. Team combo. Oh, nice tech chase on the platform by Hot Mashed Potatoes, but he doesn't get enough for interesting there. It's gaining center stage. The Fox is dead. This is doable. Metal Reaper at 37%. Ozymandias at 37%. Let's see what happens. Jab. Up throw. Oh. That's it. Game over. Alright, so... Oh, this is best of five? Alright. I teamed with a Zant today. It was a good time. Honestly, I shouldn't enter doubles unless I'm teaming with somebody, like, I know is good at doubles. I hate to rip on this kid or anything, but like, I would much rather just not play melee at that point than have to play with him, to be honest. Good stuff on beating webs. Thanks. I am lonely. Valerie's not here. Okay, so actually, the match. Ozymandias and Metal Reaper to an early lead, but Ozzy's off stage. Shine stall, but he dies off the bottom. So an even game. Stango's at high percent, but let's see what happens. I know Stango's been trying out other doubles characters that aren't Mark. I don't think his Fox is necessarily the correct character to pick, but all of his characters are really good, so I don't... especially in a scenario like this, I don't think he'll falter. That's a bad SG. The thing about Fox Puff as a team is that they kind of need to be playing close distances. And while Stango is like going out of his way, I feel like, to kind of play those distances with the Hot Mash is not cooperating with Stango at all. Like, when he threw the one Fox off stage, it's a perfect time to 2v1 the other Fox. You apply pressure, you get a grab with Stango's Fox, and then you just rest in the Hot Mash. I guess it's on last stock, so... But still. Reverse Nair, dash attack. Ooh. Metal Reaper with a clean edge guard right now. That was a good save from Hot Mash. Up smash. Alright, this game looks pretty much good. So. I want to see Stango stall the ledge for 5 minutes. I think that would be hype. Look at Sango shaking his head because he missed the LRA start. He's mad at himself. His tech skill's off. So yeah, that's game 4. I'd be interesting to see what happens in game 5. I think these are the people we're going to see in grand finals. Yeah, switching Sheik. Especially for Battlefield. Sheik's like Needle Diamond, Needle Triangle, it's just so good. It covers so much of center, and her movement just feels amazing on this stage. Oh, nice up air from Hot Mash. That's actually a really good read on the jump there. Pound. Hot Mash uses a lot of pounds. I don't think that's how he normally plays from my recollection, but in teams it's actually pretty good to throw out pounds because even if you're in lag, like, your partner will be able to come save you. Oh, I thought that would be a dash attack. Oh no, he messed up the edge guard. Hot Mash not really converting on any edge guards. And it's showing. I feel like this would be a much bigger lead if Hot Mash was able to edge guard the Foxes. I mean, it is hard. I'm not saying it's easy. There's definitely guessing involved. But he's guessed wrong pretty much every time. Oh. Yeah, you see? Just can't edgeguard at all. Oh. Oh, but Stango's got an edgeguard going. Yeah, Stango Sheik looking like the pick here. Went for a greedy double back air, but he's probably just trying to feel himself. Trying to show that he's the better player. I would have liked to see Hot Mash go off stage and drill Stango, but it wasn't worth it. Stango was like 150%. That was a really clean turnaround back here from Ledge. So, tie game as far as stocks go, but man, Hot Mash just really cannot clean up on these edge guards right now. Doesn't matter though, Stang kills him off the side. One grab rest, and this is a insurmountable lead. But at the same time, two shine spikes, and they're right back in it. Back throw. Up throw. Oh, they both went for the foxes on the platform. Ooh. Oh my god. Hamash really has not hit a single edge guard this set, from what I've seen. And this is why Stango's a good player, because he hits his. There we go. Nice. GG's. Stango sort of popped off. Not really what I'm used to seeing from him.